Hello everyone and welcome to For the Craft channel. In this video you can see how I tried to create a diorama of water flowing out of a glass. The real challenge in this diorama was how to create water from resin that looks realistic and like it is moving. So I decided to use polymer clay and try to recreate the movement of the water. In order to do this, I sculpted the ruffling of the surface of the water and, you know, all the small waves and the drops that the water would normally have if it came flowing out of a glass. Then I baked the clay for half an hour at 110 degrees Celsius. Next, I removed the baked clay from the glass and cut it in two pieces so that I could use the clay to make some silicone molds. I don't know about you, but it is very satisfying for me to watch silicone being poured. When the silicone molds were ready, I removed the clay from inside, and it was time to do the resin pouring. And when I thought that everything was going smoothly, after 48 hours when the resin cured, I faced a problem that I never faced before. When I tried to remove the resin from the silicone molds, I realized that for some unknown to me reason, the resin stuck with the silicone. Of course, I didn't expect that. This was the first time this ever happened to me. Because as we know, silicone doesn't stick with the resin, and this is why we are using silicone molds for resin. So you can imagine my frustration about the whole issue. Something that would have taken me only a few minutes to do, I mean to remove the resin from the silicone, now it took me a lot of hours trying to remove the silicone from the resin bit by bit. If you have any idea about why or how this happened, please leave a comment below. I would love to hear your opinion on this. Anyway, enough with the whining about my problems. So when I removed the silicone from the resin, I sprayed it with a gloss varnish, and it was nice and shiny again. The next step was to use a little bit of resin tinted with the same color in order to glue the water inside the glass. Then I printed a yacht model in my ANYCUBIC 3D printer. I needed to make a hull for the yacht, so I used a small piece of MDF wood. Then I primed the model and started painting it with acrylic colors and also added some details. Now, initially I was thinking to use UV resin to create the sea waves around the yacht, but then I came up with an even better solution, which was to use clear silicone, tinted with the same color as the rest of the sea. Clear silicone is much cheaper than UV resin, so you can use it at much bigger volumes, and also it is easier to shape when you make waves. So I created various waves with the clear silicone, and also added some sea foam with the white silicone. Then it was time to connect the two pieces together. To glue the pieces together, I used the UV resin, tinted with the same color as the rest of the sea. Then I created some final details on the water with the clear and white silicone, and my diorama was finished. So this is the final result, and thank you very much for watching. I hope that you like it. I also enjoyed making this, apart of course from the hours I spent removing the silicone from the resin. I would like to give a huge thank you to all of my Patreons for supporting this channel. If you would like to see additional content, behind the scenes, tips and tricks, or have a chat with me and ask for my advice, I recently created a Patreon page and I invite you to check it out. Otherwise, I wish you all a good weekend and I'll see you again next time. Cheers!